Assalamualaikum. Today we are going to do chapter number 1, which is food and digestion. Okay, so nutrients in food. Do you feel hungry looking at the different types of food in the photograph on the previous page? They are talking about these pictures that are on the previous page. So they are asking you, are you feeling hungry? Feeling hungry is a sign that our body needs food. Our bodies depend on food to give us energy to move around and carry out important life processes. So food provide us with, so there are some points that food provide us with. Number one, food provide us energy to do work and carry out the vital functions in our bodies. Number two is the materials needed for the growth of new cells and the repair of damaged cells. So food is providing us, number one is the energy, so that we can do the work and we can carry out the important functions for our bodies. Number two, it provides the material that are needed for the growth and then the new cells of the growth and the repair of the damaged cells. Number three, we have substances that our bodies need for healthy and resisting diseases. Food store energy and contain nutrients which are essential to our bodies. The different type of nutrients in food may be classified as follows. So these are the essential different type of nutrients in the food: carbohydrates, fats, proteins, fibers, minerals, vitamins and water. So most type of food contain a mix of different nutrients. However, certain type of food are richer in particular nutrients than the other. So moving on to number one, which is the carbohydrate. Carbohydrates supply our bodies with most of the energy that we need. So carbohydrates are a compound made up of the elements like carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Carbohydrate includes sugars and complex carbohydrates. Sugar includes simple sugars such as glucose and fructose. They are the simplest form of sugars, the glucose and the fructose. And the complex sugars such as lactose, which is a complex sugar from the milk, maltose and sucrose, the cane sugar. So in the simple sugars, we have the glucose and fructose. And in the complex sugars such as lactose, maltose and sucrose, in lactose we have the milk, in maltose and sucrose we have the cane sugar. Cellulose, which makes up the plant cell wall, and starch are complex carbohydrates. So over here we have number two, which is the starch. Starch is found in food such as in rice, potatoes, bread, cereals, noodles, yam, cassava, beans and grains. So these are all the food that the starch is present in. Okay, now we move on to people from different societies obtain carbohydrates from different food sources as shown in the photograph below. I've already shown you the picture. These are the picture they are talking about. Now identify the source of carbohydrate for each type of meal below. What is your main source of carbohydrate? So if you see over here, there is a picture of a Western meal in which they have the fries, the beans, carrots, mushrooms and some a little steak sort of a thing. If we see the second, which is a Malay meal, the Malaysian food, they have a lot of different things. They have the spices, they have the salads, they have the chicken and all these sort of things. And in this third one, it's a Chinese meal, and everyone knows that Chinese contains some rice, some boiled rice, some chicken along with some vegetables, and this is also I think cashew nuts along with the chicken. And then we have an Indian meal, which is a thali that contains a lot of things like dal and the rice and the raita and the chilies and grains like that. And I think in the E we have the Italian meal, and everyone knows that Italians have pastas and pizzas. So you have to tell the source of carbohydrate for each type of meal below. So this is just a question, you need to answer that. Moving on to the next one. Now we will see this test for the starch. How we will know that a certain food contains a starch or not. So the process of starch in food can be tested by the use of iodine. So if I'll ask you, what test we do to identify either starch is present in the food or not? So you are going to tell me it's iodine. It's the iodine solution. So a blue-black color is obtained if iodine solution is added to the starch. So like see over here, this is an orange iodine solution. If we add the iodine solution, if the starch is present in that particular solution, it will change the color from the orange to a blue black, which is mixed with the starch. So this is the test for the starch. If I'll show you a little about the detail as well. So it's a chemical test for, basically, for the starch is to add the iodine solution. Iodine solution is basically a yellow brown, and look for a color change. So this actually has a yellow brown color. So we are looking for a change in the presence of starch. The iodine turns this blue black color. It will change into from the yellow brown to the blue black color. You see over here, it's a bluish black color. So it is possible to distinguish starch from the glucose and other carbohydrates using the iodine solution test. Moving on to sugars. Sugars are found naturally in fruits, sugarcane, and milk. Sugars are used to make chocolates, candies, cakes, and soft drinks. Food or drink made from the refined sugars, such as candies and soft drinks, provide us with a lot of energy but little of other nutrients. Hence, it is not advisable to take too much of them. So what they are saying over here, that sugars, they make up, we make from the sugars, we make the chocolate, candies, cookies, soft drinks, all those sort of things that everyone really likes to eat, or fruits and drinks, maybe refined sugar. So we are refining the sugar, such as the candies and the soft drinks, that provide us with a lot of energy but little of the other nutrients. So it is of more energy, like sugar has like energy, but with very little other nutrients that are actually essential. So that is why it is advisable that to not take much of them. Excess carbohydrates in the body are converted by the body to fats and stored. So if we take excessive amount of the carbohydrates, what our body is going to do? Our body will convert that carbohydrate to fats, and fats are stored. Fats are something that is not soluble and they are stored. That's why people get fat by having a lot of sugars, candies, gums, chocolates, all sort of things. Over here they have shown us the pretty pictures of the things that we actually really like but are not actually really healthy. Over here we have the cold drinks, some cookies along with the chocolate, some juices and food, and some pastries, cakes. So these are the foods that are rich in sugars. So for the sugars, we are going to do the test called the glucose test. The presence of the simple sugars, glucose can be tested by using the Banneret solution. So in order to see the presence of simple sugar, we are going to do a test called the glucose test, which can be tested by using a Banneret solution. So for the simple sugar glucose test, the solution that we are going to use will be the Banneret solution, which is light blue in color. When an equal amount of Banneret solution and glucose solution are mixed and heated, an orange red precipitate is found. So you see over here, if we add the equal amount of the Banneret solution and the equal amount of glucose solution, the mixture will turn into orange red precipitate. So this is the diagram they have showing you. Orange red precipitate forms when Banneret solution is mixed with the glucose. So if I'll tell you a little more detail, the Banneret solution is used to test for simple carbohydrates. The Banneret test identifies the reducing sugars. And what are the reducing sugars? The monosaccharides and the disaccharides, which have free ketones or the aldehyde functional group. So Banneret solution can be used to test for the presence of glucose in the urine. Okay, moving on to fats. Like carbohydrates, fats are compounds made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. However, fats have less oxygen in proportion to hydrogen. So over here, fats, they have less oxygen than the proportion of hydrogen. Fats give more than twice the energy as the same amount of carbohydrates. Fats serve as a reserve supply of energy when food consumption is low and help to keep us warm. So what they're saying over here, that the fat, they serve supply of energy when the food consumption is low. So if the food consumption is low, fat will serve as a reserve supply, because they're already stored. That way we are calling it reserve. Reserve means stored, or reserve means it is already there, and help to keep us warm. However, too much fat in our body can lead to health problems like the heart diseases, because at the end, fats, they are not good for the health. Fats from animals can be found in butter. Okay, from the animals, if we see fats, we can find in the butter. Butter contains fats. Lard, meat, cheese, and milk, while fats from the plants. Okay, so these are the things that we get from the animals, like the butter, lard, meat, cheese, and the milk. While the fats from the plants, we found it in the margarine, nuts, cooking oil such as the peanut oil, palm oil, or the olive oil. So over here, these are the things we get the fats from the animals and from the plants. So plant oils and oils from the fatty fish such as salmon and mackerel, these are the two types of fishes, provide us with the healthy fats. Okay, so the fat which we get from the fish, particularly the salmon and the mackerel, they are actually pretty healthy for us. Animal fats such as lard and butter, these are the two types of, lard is also a type of a meat, and butter have high level of unhealthy fats and should be consumed sparingly, means in a less amount. So if we are doing over here the test for the fats, the process of fat in food can be tested by using the ethanol. So for the test of fat, we are using a solution called the ethanol. You must know all these solutions. For the glucose, we'll use the Benedict solution. For the starch, we use the iodine solution. So these are something that you should remember. Okay, so for this, we will use the ethanol, a kind of alcohol. When a little ethanol is added to a drop of oil and mix well, because we said fat oils are also fats. So we are using just a drop of ethanol in the oil and we'll mix that. A clear solution is formed. If some water is added to this clear mixture, a white emulsion, fat dispersed in water, is formed. So if you see over here the diagram, okay, so over here they also mentioned and showed you the food that contains the fats. Over here we have some milk, we have nuts, we have juices, we have butters, and over here we have lard, like the meat. So they are showing you over here the test for the fats. What they are showing you, that the ethanol that is mixed with some oil, you see this is the drop of the oil and this is the ethanol. If the presence of fat is there, white emulsion will form. This is the white emulsion that will form when the fats are present. So moving on to the other part, which is the protein. Proteins are actually very important. Protein can consist of long chains of amino acids, which are made up of elements like the carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. So they are basically, proteins are the long chains of the amino acids, and they are made up of the elements called the carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. So there are about 20 different types of amino acids, which link up and combine in different ways to form the millions of different types of proteins. Okay, so for the test, you need to see this video, and I will also post another video for the carbohydrate, protein, fats, and all of that. They also have like a complete description, complete detail to that. So from there you can see the proteins, and we'll just do the test in this video, and I'll also link another video just may you have will have the detail for all the essential nutrients that are the carbohydrate, protein, fats, and all of that. So testing for the protein, the presence of soluble solution protein is found in food can be tested by using the Barrett solution. So for the protein, we are going to use the Barrett solution, which is a mixture of sodium hydroxide solution and a small amount of copper sulfate solution. So in the test of protein, we have the mixture of sodium hydroxide and a copper sulfate solution. A change to the violet color is observed. Violet is like a purple sort of a color when the blue Barrett solution is mixed with the protein. So basically the presence of, okay, absence of proteins, if the protein is not present, it will be a color like blue, and if the protein is present, the color will change from blue to the violet color, which is like a purple sort of a color. Okay, so over here we have the fibers and we have the vitamins. I will link the other video so that you can see from there the vitamins and the fiber. Let's see the sources of the dietary fibers. So this is the picture of the source of the dietary fibers. We have some nuts, we have some corns, broccoli, we have some papaya, cucumbers, guava, and some spinach, and I think these are some mangoes or maybe watermelon sort of thing. Okay, over here vitamins. Why? Okay, let me just read out for you a little. Fibers or the rohage. Okay, rohage is another name of the fiber. It is made up of the cellulose, which cannot be broken down by the bodies. Fibers are actually hard, so it passes right through the body and leave a solid waste in the form of feces. The right amount of fiber in our diet keep our intestine healthy and working properly. Without fiber in the diet, one may suffer from constipation. So fiber is really important. Otherwise, one will suffer from the constipation. What the fiber is going to do over here, that it passes right through the body and leave a solid feces in the solid waste in the form of feces. The right amount of fiber in the diet keep our intestine healthy. So fiber basically is important because it will keep our body healthy and working properly. Fruits, vegetables. Okay, what food contains fibers? The fruits, vegetables, brown rice, cereals, wheatmeal bread. Whole wheat bread are examples of the food which are that are really rich in fiber. So these things should be taken. Then we have the vitamins. They are needed in the small amount by our bodies for the health and growth. Lack of vitamins in the diet can lead to deficiency diseases. Okay, if one is one don't have the enough amount of the vitamin, it will lead to deficiency diseases such as scurvy. Scurvy is the bleeding gum, that your gum will bleed whenever you brush your teeth or whenever you eat something hard. If you bite it, your gums start to bleed. And rickets, that is stunted growth and softening of bones and the teeth. So over here they are showing us the picture of a person who is suffering from scurvy, and over here this is a person suffering from the rickets. You see what they said, this stunted growth and softening of the bones and teeth. Because of the softening of the bones, you see the legs feel stilted. Okay, then we have this entire you can say the what we call it, this is a table for vitamins, their functions, their deficiency problems and their food sources, that what food should we take in order to get rid of these deficiencies. You have to read all of these one by one on your own, and if you have any question you can just ask. So over here they continue with the vitamins. We have some minerals over here. They are substances needed by the body in the tiny amounts for the proper growth and the development. They are needed in some body tissues and are used in some chemical reactions of the body. Okay, so the table below shows some important minerals. Okay, this is the table that is showing some important minerals. Important minerals includes calcium, iron, iodine and sodium. These are their functions. Calcium for building the strong bone and the teeth, for the muscle growth and the contraction, clotting of the blood, and this is the food source. What we eat, so we'll get these functions. If we eat the dairy products, green vegetables and eggs, we'll get strong bones and teeth, muscle growth and contraction and all like so. So you have to go through this table again, and if still you feel any question you can ask. Okay, now we move on to the water. Water does not provide us with energy, but it plays vital role in many life processes. So water is not giving us the energy, but it plays a really vital role in many life processes. You always heard people saying you drink enough water, have enough water. Why they are saying? Because without water, we will die very quickly. So water makes up about the 70% of the body mass. It is needed for breaking down the food, dissolving the nutrients and transporting them around our bodies. So water is the main constituent of the cells and the blood plasma, the liquid part of the blood. Chemical reactions can only take place in the cytoplasm of the cell, which contain enough water. So we lose a lot of water daily through our precipitation, through urine and the air we breathe out. So the air that we breathe out, so how are we going to lose the water? By the precipitations, by the urine, the form of urine, and while air we breathe out. The water lost must be replaced. So if we are losing the water, we should it should be replaced, means it should be refilled. An average person need about 2 to 3 liters of water, which equivalents to 6 to 8 glasses per day. We must also attain water by eating food, such as if you take juicy fruits that are rich in water. So these are some of the picture of the juicy fruits. If you take like the guava, you have grapes, oranges, bananas, spinach, we have apples, watermelon, and we have some mango. Okay, so this is the picture of a person suffering from the goiter. So So goiter over here, if you see in the iodine for making hormones of the thyroid gland, deficiency leads to goiter. So this mineral iodine, what is the function of iodine? It will make the hormones of the thyroid gland. So deficiency of this iodine will lead to goiter, a swelling of the thyroid gland in the lower neck. If you see in the diagram, this is the swelling of the thyroid gland in the lower neck area. So that is why these minerals are really, really important. Okay, so then we have some key points, and this is the energy value for the food. Like whatever we take, like the carbohydrates, fats, proteins, and you know the main supplies of the energy. This is the energy level they have shown. And so on, they says you the key points. You should read out all these key points. And this is a balanced diet. Okay, moving on to a topic called the balanced diet. Your diet is what you eat and drink. So what is a balanced diet? A balanced diet is what you eat and drink. A varied diet consists of different types of food which will supply us with the energy and different types of nutrients which our body needs. So milk and dairy products includes cheese, you see, meat and alternatives. Okay, so bread and cereals, and we have fruits and vegetables. So over here what they are saying, in order to keep a balanced diet, you have to eliminate these things from the others. How? If you eliminate milk and the dairy products from the wheat, meat and the alternatives. Alternative means you can have meat, or either you can have eggs, or you can have fish, or you can have chicken. Instead of having the bread and the cereals, you can have fruits and vegetables. You see over here, fruits and vegetables. Okay, so this is a varied. Okay, over here they have shown you the graph for the balanced diet. You can look up to that as well. And then we have, beside energy requirement, people may have other special foods or the needs. For example, a growing child needs plenty of proteins for making new tissues. A pregnant mother needs extra protein, iron and calcium for the developing fetus. An athlete needs proteins for building the muscles and plenty of simple sugars for the instant energy. So this actually varies. This balanced diet will vary from person to person. If you are a growing child, you need plenty of proteins for making the new tissues. And if you are a pregnant woman, you need to have extra protein and iron and calcium because you are developing a fetus, you're developing another, you're going to give a birth to a child. And if you are an athlete, if you are a sport person, you need to have proteins for building the muscles and plenty of simple sugars for the instant energy. Over here they have shown you a balanced diet that contains the right amount of the energy, like the carbohydrate, protein, fat, fiber, like all things you need to have. You need to have all kind of carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamin, minerals and water to meet the requirement of the body. Over here they have shown you a little pyramid sort of a thing for the balanced diet, and these are some other points, and inshallah we will do the digestion in our next class. So this is it for the lecture. If you still have any questions and queries, you can just ask me. I will upload the lecture and I will see you in my next class. Take care and Allah Hafiz.